Do you know that the cost of quality accounts for 20 to 30% of the company's total sales revenue? Every organization wants to reduce their percentage, but they fail to do so because they don't understand the difference between the cost of good quality and the cost of poor quality. So if you are one of those or know someone, then this video is especially for you. So in this short video, I have explained the concept of cost of good quality and cost of poor quality along with some relevant examples. And I've also explained the quality cost curve. So don't go anywhere else, just sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. Hello, and welcome to yet another video series from Digital E-Learning, your one-stop solution for all your learning needs. So what is cost of quality? The term cost of quality is actually confusing a lot of people. The cost of quality is the total expenses incurred by an organization in achieving and maintaining the good quality, as well as managing the poor quality with aim of achieving the customer satisfaction. The overall cost of quality help us make decision as to how much we need to invest in the quality. Quality cost does not just relate to manufacturing. Rather, they are related to all the activities from initial research and development, that is R&D, all the way to the customer service. So the complete product life cycle and not just the project life cycle is included while delivering the cost of quality. Phillips Crosby, who gave this concept, once said, "Money is the language of management. You need to show them the numbers." This was true when he first said it many years ago, and even today it is relevant. Since then, the cost of quality concept has been continuously improved into fully developed financial model. Phillips Crosby demonstrated what a powerful tool it can be to raise the awareness of the importance of quality. As defined by Phillips Crosby in his book, Quality is Free, this is where the cost of quality perspective can be very powerful in that it helps you understand where you are investing or wasting your money. That is, are you spending your money preventing defects and assuring quality, or are you spending your money performing rework and handling customer complaints? This perspective can also help you understand the difference between the actual cost of product you are producing and what cost could be if your quality was perfect. Phillips Crosby defined the cost of quality as two components: cost of good quality and cost of poor quality. He further bifurcated the cost of good quality into two sections: appraisal cost and prevention cost, and also the cost of poor quality as the internal failure cost and the external failure cost. Let us look at each one of these in more detail. So the cost of quality is basically a sum of two components: cost of poor quality and cost of good quality. So when we talk about cost of good quality, which is also known as cost of conformance, is the cost involved in making certain things which are done in the right way first time, which includes prevention cost and appraisal cost. So when we talk about the prevention cost, these are the costs which are incurred to prevent or avoid quality problems. These costs are associated with design, implementation, and maintenance of quality management system. They are planned and incurred before actual operation. In short, these are the costs arise from the efforts to prevent defects from the system. So example could be your quality assurance cost. Few other examples that we can have under this category could be establishing the product specification, quality planning, new product development and testing, development of quality management system, and proper employee training. And when we talk about the appraisal cost, it is the cost that arises from the efforts to detect the defects. Example could be the quality control cost, including the incoming materials inspection, process controls, check fixtures, quality audits, and supplier assessment. So cost of good quality is basically a combination of prevention cost and appraisal cost. And when we talk about cost of poor quality, this is the cost or the money that is wasted when work failed to meet the customer requirement, which includes your internal and external failure cost, and is usually calculated by quantifying the cost of correcting, reworking, scrapping, warranties, which correspond to the failure cost. So where we have the internal failure cost are the costs which are incurred to correct defects discovered before the product or service is delivered to the end customer. Example could be the cost of rework, like fixing an internal defect or retesting it, excessive scraps, product rework, or waste due to the poorly designed process, machine breakdown. So these are the examples of internal failure cost. So when we talk about the external failure cost, so these are the costs that incurred when the product or service have been shipped to the end customer and we receive some failed to satisfy the design quality standards, and these are not detected until it is transferred to the customer. So this could be in the form of service and repair cost, warranty claims, customer complaints, product and material returns, incorrect sales order, incomplete BOM, shipping damage due to inadequate packaging. So this internal failure cost and external failure cost will give you the cost of poor quality. And when you add both this cost of poor quality and cost of good quality, you will get the total cost of quality, which is nothing but the simply a sum of prevention cost, appraisal cost, and the failure cost, including both internal and external. Quality cost curve. The goal of quality cost curve is to find the level of quality that minimizes the total cost of quality. This is because the associated cost of non-quality increases exponentially as the product moves from manufacturing to distribution and finally to the end customer. So in this quality cost curve, the x-axis represents the quality level, which moves from 0% conformance on the left to the 100% conformance on the right, and y-axis represents the cost per goods unit of production. So as you move from 0% conformance to 100% conformance on the quality level, the prevention cost and the appraisal cost increases linearly, and the failure costs, which is a sum of internal and external, will begin to decrease sharply. And the total cost of quality, which is a sum of prevention cost, appraisal cost, and the failure cost, will also decrease sharply. One key conclusion that Juran is communicating via this quality cost curve is that the total cost of quality is lowest at a point where the conformance is 100%. At this point, the total cost simply equals the cost of prevention and appraisal, and there is no component of failure cost. A general rule of thumb, that is 1 to 10 to 100 rule, which means that $1 spent on prevention will save $10 on appraisal and $100 on the failure cost. In short, it means that when compared to prevention activities costing $1, the poor quality, it is 10 times more costly than identified during the appraisal cost and 100 times more costly when identified after the product has been shipped. So it is better to invest in prevention activities that will reduce your appraisal cost and finally your failure cost. So investment in prevention activities offers the best return. Let us see some of the strategies that we can employ to control this cost. So the first strategy that we can use is to eliminate the failure cost. That is, we should take a direct attack on the failure cost in an attempt to drive them to zero. We should try to eliminate the failure cost at all from the system. Next is to invest in right prevention activities to bring about more continuous improvement. Reduce the appraisal cost according to the results that you achieve from testing. And finally, continuously improve and evaluate and redirect prevention efforts to gain further improvement in your process. Let us look at some examples here. We'll start with prevention cost. So under prevention cost, we have training, process capability studies, process validation, forecasting, prototyping, testing, market research and survey. Under appraisal cost, we have inspection and testing, product and process audit, calibration, document and drawing check, measurement equipment. Under internal failure, we can have rework, scraps, accidents, sorting, and corrective action. And under external failure, we have complaints from customer, return goods and product recalls, warranty claims, penalties, and goodwill and bad debt, and lost sales. So that is all I have on this video. See you soon in my next video.